अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः येन धौता गिरः पुंसां विमलैः शब्दवारिभिः तमश्चाज्ञानजं भिन्नं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारञ्च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम् ॐ नमः पाणिनिकात्यायनपतञ्जलिभ्यः शब्दविद्यासम्प्रदायप्रवर्तकेभ्यो मुनिभ्यो महद्भ्यो गुरुभ्यः In this class, we will start with this 35th rule. Eka vibhakti cha apurva nipate. Ita purvam ekam sutram asit. Prathama nirdishtam samasa upasarjanam. Samasya shastre ఉపసర్జనం నామ సంజ్ఞితం సమాస విధాన సూత్రేషు యత్ ప్రథమా విభక్తియా నిర్దిశ్యతే తద్ ఉపసర్జన సంజ్ఞితం భవతి ఇన్ ద ప్రీవియస్ క్లాస్ వీ హవ్ డెల్ట్ విత్ దిస్ రూల్ ఇన్ ద సమాస శాస్త్ర ఇన్ ది సూత్రాస్ ఇంపోజింగ్ samasas in the samasa sutram the word indicated by prathama vibhakti is termed upasarjanam this name has been given to it so that upasarjanam purvam in samasa the word called upasarjanam will be taken as the first word in the samasa. Tadartham upasarjana sanya krita. Here, eka vibhakti cha upasarjanam bhavati samase. Samase eka vibhaktikam api upasarjanam bhavati kintu apurva nipate. That means a little deviation from the previous rule. Previous rule says, whatever in the Samasa Vidhana Sutram, whatever Prathama Vibhaktiya Riddhishtam Vartate, Tadeva Upasarjanam. Here, Samase, this word has to be taken as Samasa Vakya Kalpana Kale. When we write the Samasa Vigraha Vakyam, Samasa Ardha Vigraha Vakyam, when we write that, whatever the word Vibhakti, here, eka vibhakti means, eka means niyati, niyatikam. That means fixed. It won't vary. In several vigraha vakyas, a particular word is fixed in a particular vibhakti. Then, that particular word which has been fixed in the fixed vibhakti, that is called upasarjanam. But, as before, this type of upasarjanam will not be taken as the first word in the samasa, but it will be apurva nipataha, purvam na nipatyate, parameva nipatyate. It will be taken as the second word only. Vitiya padam bhavati, natu prathama padam. That is the ruling of this sutra. Here, eka vibhaktikam means fixed, in the fixed vibhakti. That means dvitiya padam bahubhi vibhakti bhi prayujyate api. Even though the dvitiya padam is used in different several vibhaktis, prathama padam, if it is used only in a fixed vibhakti, that padam will be taken as upasarjanam. But it will not be Purvanipatitam. That means it will be Paranipatitam only. It will be taken in the Samasa as the second word only. We will take a particular example. Kaushambi is the place of a city in olden days. A person who has gone out of this city of Kaushambi, Nishkrantaha Kaushambyaha, ityarthe samasaha bhavati. The sutram here is, samasa sutram is, this is pradi samasa. Niradayaha krantadhyardhe panchamya is the rule. That is, niradi pradayaha, niradi avyayani, they are called pradi. Niradi pradayaha panchami vibhakti sahita shabdena, panchami vibhaktiya upayukta shabdena, krantaha ityardhe samaso bhavati, saha pradi samasaha iti uchyate. We will take this vigraha vakyam. We will take the vigraha vakyam several ways. First vigraha vakyam is nishkrantaha kaushambyaha. Kaushambyaha iti panchamyantam shabda. That means he has crossed over the Kaushambi city. So, nishkrantaha, krantadhyardhe bhavati, nishkrantaha tat nirriti avyayam pradihi bhavati, tarihi nir with kaushambi, it will be become a samasa. So, nir nishkaushambi will be the samasa. Here, this kaushambi is a stri pratyayanta shabdaha. According to a coming rule, this stri pratyayanta will become raswa, so kaushambi will become kaushambi. Nishkaushambihi will be the final shape of the samasa. The vigraha vakyam is nishkrantaha kaushambyaha. In the vigraha vakya, written as follows, that is, nishkrantam kaushambyaha. There also, nishkaushambim will be the form of the samasa. Here, nishkrantam, that is, dvitiya vibhakti. In the first vigraha, nishkrantaha iti prathama vibhakti. In this second vakya, this is dvitiya vibhakti. But kaushambi, kaushambyaha iti panchamyantam eva vartate. Prathama vigraha vakya api panchamyantam, dvitiya vigraha vakya api panchamyantam. Evameva nishkrantena kaushambyaha iti nishkaushambina tritiya vibhakti. Here also, kaushambyaha in panchami only. Nishkrantena iti tritiya. The nishkranta shabdaha is in tritiya. First it is in prathama vibhakti, second dvitiya vibhakti, now third tritiya vibhakti. But this kaushambyaha iti shabdaha panchamyantam eva bhavati. So also, nishkrantaya kaushambyaha. Nishkaushambi will be the, but here we have to use chaturdhi, nishkaushambaye, because nishkaushambi is the pumlinga word. The person, the gentleman who has crossed Nishkaushambi nagaram. Evam eva nishkrantat kaushambyaha, nishkaushambehe will be the format. Evam cha nishkrantasya kaushambyaha, it will be nishkaushambehe, ikaranta pullinga shabdaha. Finally, Niskranta Shabdasya Panchami, Saptami, Niskrante Kaushambhyaha, Niskaushambhau. In all this Vigraha Vakya, Niskranta Shabdaha is in different vibhaktis. But Kaushambhyaha iti fixed vibhakti, Panchamyantameva. Because the samasa sutra says, Niradayaha Krantadhyardhe Panchamya. So, in these Vigraha Vakyas, because Kaushambi, the word Kaushambi is in a fixed Vibhakti, that is Panchami, that is called Eka Vibhaktihi. Samasa Vigraha Vakyeshu, Eka Vibhaktihi, Shabdaha, Kaushambyahaiti. So, this will be the Upasarjanam here, but it will not be taken as the Purva Nipataha. It will not be coming in the first place in the samasa. So, niskaushambi, niskaushambihi, niskaushambim, niskaushambina, ityadi. So, niskaushambihi. So, this kaushambi letter, this word kaushambi, even though it is upasarjanam, it is taken as the dvitiya padam. So, that is the meaning of this. This Nishkaushambi iti, Nishkaushambi iti original form of the samasa, this Nishkaushambi ityasya stri pratyayasya rasvaha abhavat. Because this is upasarjanam, according to the coming rule, gostriyor upasarjanasya iti, this is stri pratyayantaha, this is upasarjanam, so it will be changed into rasva. Evameva nirvaranasihi. Niskrantaha Varanasya Varanasyaha. Niskrantam Varanasyaha. Niskrantena Varanasyaha. Evam. Nirvaranasihi will be the format. Now, why it is told Eka Vibhaktikam? Suppose in several Vigraha Vakyas containing these two words, Prathama Padam and Dithiya Padam, a Padam in different vibhaktis will not be called an upasarjanam. We will take an example. Rajakumari iti example. In one vigraha vakya, Rajnaha Kumari. Rajakumari. That is the daughter of a king. Rajnaha itself is a Sashtyantam. Rajnyasya should not be told. Rajan Shabdasya Rajnyaha iti Sashti. Rajnyaha Kumari. Rajnyaha Kumarim. Rajakumarim. Rajnyaha Kumariya. Rajakumariya. So on and so forth in all the vibhaktis. So here in this Vigraha Vakya, Rajnyaha Kumari. Kumari Shabdasya Vibhakti hi ekaha na bhavati, ekaha na bhavati. It is varying. Kumari, first Kumari, Kumarim, Kumariya. As in the previous example, Kaushambi is in a fixed vibhakti. Here it is not so. So this Kumari Shabdaha, this Tri Pratyayanta Shabdaha will not be a upasarjanam. So it will be this, it will not take Raswa. Rajakumari. Upasarjanam apurva nipataha bhavati atra ityuktam. Kimardham etad uktam? I mean, this upasarjana word will not be taken as the prathama padam. Apurva nipataha. Purva nipataha na bhavati. Purva nipataha ityukte Nipatitaha Purvam. Samase, it is taken as, it falls as the first word. So, Nir Kaushambi, this is the Samasa emanating from two words. Nir is Pradi, Kaushambi is the second. So, Kaushambi, it should be Paranipatita Shabdaha. So if it is not told as apurva nipate, we may mistake it as purva nipataha. So it will not be purva nipataha. That means kaushambi nir iti samaso navavati. Kaushambi has to take the second place only. This is regarding the 35th rule. We'll go to the next sutra, 36. Ardhavat adhatuhu apratyayaha pratipadikam. I have divided the sandhis. Ardhavad adhatur apratyayaha. Ardhavad is one word. Adhatuhu apratyayaha. This is the sanya sutram regarding pratipadika sanya. What is pratipadikam? I have not written. Yes. Ardhavat adhatura pratyaya pratipadikam. I should have written there. This is the complete sutra. This is Pratipadika Sanya Sutram. It clarifies what Pratipadikam means. Pratipadikam should be Ardhavat. Ardhavat means Ardha Shabdat Matu Prachayaha. It contains an Ardha. Ardha means a sense, a meaning, a fixed meaning. It contains a fixed meaning. Ardhavat Shabda Swarupam Pratipadikam Bhavati. That means a Pratipadikam is a word which contains a definite sense, a definite meaning. Ardhavat means having Ardha in itself. Ardhavat Shabda Swarupam Pratipadikam Bhavati. Dhatumcha Pratyayamcha Varjayitva. That adhatuhu apratyayaha is used there. That means dhatum varjayitva, na dhatuhu adhatuhu, na pratyayaha, pratyayam varjayitva. Here, pratyaya should be taken not only pratyaya, but pratyayantam. That also is to be taken. A pratyaya is a particular pratyaya. A shabda with that pratyaya in the end will be called pratyayantam. So, pratyayantam api varjaniyam. That means dhatum cha pratyayam cha pratyayantam cha varjayitva ardhavat shabda swarupam pratipadikam iti uchyate. So a pratipadikam is a word which contains a definite sense, a definite meaning, but it is told dhatum varjayitva. A dhatu should not be taken as pratipadikam. Even though dhatu also has got a particular meaning. How dhatu contains a meaning? We have been referring to dhatu, several dhatu we have taken in the last chapter. Kidvat prakaranam and nidvat. We have taken so many dhatus. Wherever a dhatu has come, we have told the dhatu patha also. Dhatu patha contains the specific meaning of that dhatu. The meaning in which that dhatu is to be used. For example, bhu, bhu sattayam, sattayaha visaye, bhu dhatuhu upayoktavyaha. So, satta means existence. In the meaning of existence, bhu dhatu is to be used. Dukri karane, in the meaning of doing, doing a work, kru dhatu is to be used. So, dhatu pata contains the meanings of dhatus. So, dhatu also is a shabda swarupam. That is why it is accepted here. It is barred here from Pratipadika Sanya. We will see why it is barred Pratipadika Sanya. So also a Pratyaya. Pratyaya also is barred. After all, Pratyaya also contains some meaning. For example, we have got so many Pratyayas. We have come across so many Pratyayas. For example, Tavya Pratyaya. Aniya Pratyaya. Datavya. We have told A thing which has to be given, which had to be given, which is to be given. To be given is the meaning of that tavya. Daniya, karaniya, kartavya. All these pratyayas, tavya. Tuman also has got a meaning. Tun nulau kriyardhayam kriyayam. That is meaning is told there in the sutra. So these are all pratyayas. They are also shabdas. They have got a definite meaning. That is why it should be excluded from Pratipadika Sanya. We will see whatever happens if it is given Pratipadika Sanya. So also Pratyayanta Shabdaha. Pratyayanta Shabdaha api, that has to be excluded from Pratipadikam. That means Kartavya, Karaniya, Datavya, Daniya. So also these are all Pratyayanta Shabdas. They should not be taken as Pratipadikam. As per this rule. So, what are the examples for this Ardhavata Shabda Swarupam, which is not Dhatu, which is not Pratyaya, which is not Pratyayanta? It means it should have some definite meaning. But we have been accustomed to many words having a Prakriti as also a Pratyaya. And when Prakriti and Pratyaya are added together only, it is giving a meaning. For example, Dhatavya. Da means to give. Tavya means a must and must should, it should be done. Tavya means it should be done. Vidhi. So, when you combine these two, that gives a certain sense. To give, that only does not give a sense. That should be done, that is not giving a sense. So, Dhatuhu, that is Prakritihi. Tavya is Pratyaya. When Prakriti and Pratyaya are combined only, it is giving a definite Shabda Swarupam. But grammarians in the earlier days, they were divided into two groups. Some grammarians maintained that every word in Sanskritam has got a Prakriti, has got a Pratyayam. Prakriti Pratyaya Vibhagasya Jnanam Eva Samskrita Jnanam. That means every word can be divided into two parts, two limbs. One limb is Prakriti, another limb is Pratyaya. Just as this whole creation is Prakriti Pratyaya Swarupaha. That means Stri. Prakriti means Stri, Pratyaya means Purusha. Stritvam and Purushatvam. The combination of Sthritvam and Purushatvam is only the entire manifestation of creation. So also, Sanskrit creation is also Prakriti Pratyaya Vidhanam. So when that is the case, that is the argument of certain persons. Every word in Sanskritam, you bring any word here, I will divide it into Prakriti and Pratyayam. I will say this has got a definite meaning because of the combination of Prakriti and Pratyaya. That is one Vyutpattivada. This is called a Vyutpattivada, an argumentation that every word can be divided into two limbs, and the two limbs connected together will give a definite meaning. But a different vada is there, Avyutpattivada, Avyutpannavada. What do they say? No, it is not so. There are so many words which cannot be divided into two parts, but it gives a definite sense. For example, one person has named his beloved ox as Dittha. He used to call his ox, Dittha, Dittha, come here, my ox. It has got a definite meaning. It is the name of an ox, but it cannot be divided into two limbs. There is no Prakriti, there is no Pratyaya with these names. So this is, it need not be divided into two limbs because it contains a definite meaning. It is also a name, it is also a Pratipadikam. So also Kapittha. Kapittha is the name of a tree. What do they say in English? Kapittha. Wood apple tree. Because wood apple tree. And that's the apples born, arising out of woods only, forests. So this Kapitha Shabda also cannot be divided into two limbs. There is no Prakriti Pratyaya Vibhaga there. But it gives a definite meaning, so that should be taken as Pratipadikam. Kundam. Here, Kundam means a pot. That also cannot be divided into two limbs. But it is a Shabda. It can be called Pratipadikam. Peetam. That has no Prakriti Pratyaya Vibhaga. No two limbs. No Dhatu is there, no Pratyaya is there. But that is a Shabda. Being widely used. Vidya Peetam. Advaita Peetam, Visishta Advaita Peetam, so also. So these are the examples of Ardhavat Shabda Swarupam as per the Avyutpanna Vada. So in this Avyutpanna Vada, a word like Rama is a Shabda, Ardhavat Shabda Swarupam, it can be taken as Pratipadika. But what is the meaning they have given? Rama, they have not divided into Prakriti and Pratyaya. They are Abhyutpanna Vada, Vadinaha. So they said Rama means Dasharatha's son. A Dasharatha, Dasharatha has given a name, just as I have given a name for my ox as Ditta, Dasharatha has given a name Rama to his son. But Vyutpanna Vadinaha, what do they say? No, there is a Vyutpatti there. Ramante asmin munayaha. That is Ram dhatuhu. Ram, delight, delighting. Ram dhatuhu on that ghai pratyayaha. So this is Prakriti Pratyaya Vibhagita, Vibhaktaha. So Rama plus ghai will become Rama. So Rama will become Pratipadikam not according to this rule. This rule, if you take only examples of Ditta, etc., Kapitha, etc., which cannot be divided into two limbs, Rama cannot be an example. So, for making such Shabdas, because Rama is Pratyayantaha, why it is not a Shabda as per this rule, as Pratipadikam as per this rule? This Pratipadikam says, Apratyayantaha. A Pratyayanta word cannot be taken as Pratipadikam as per this rule. So, next he is going to invent another rule to accommodate a great number of words like Rama who are Pratyayanta Shabdas. So, as per this rule, as far as this rule is concerned, we are giving the example of Ditta, Kapitha, Peetam, Ichari. Why we are telling Ardhavat Shabda Swarupam? Udaharanartham, suppose Anardhavat Shabda Swarupam is taken as Pratipadikam, what is the harm? Suppose a Dhatu is taken as a Pratipadikam, what is the harm? Suppose a Pratyaya is taken as a Pratipadikam, what is the great harm? So we have to answer all these questions. So he goes on to answer these questions. Why he has told Ardhavat Shabda Swarupam? That means Anardhavat Shabda Swarupam cannot be taken as Pratipadikam. For example, we have got a word Vanam. So also Dhanam. Vanam has got a meaning. Vanam means forest. Dhanam means money. But Nakaranta Shabda Swarupam here, Van and Dhan, they do not contain any meaning. So they cannot be taken as Pratipadikams. What is the harm if they are taken as Pratipadikams? Means, if you take one as a Pratipadikam, after all, what is the object in taking this Pratipadikam? We are supposed to enjoy in Supratyayas and Tadita Pratyayas onto these Pratipadikams. Supratyayas will be enjoyed into Pratipadikam. Tadita Pratyayas. For example, Supratyaya, Rama plus Prathama Vibhakti Ekavachanam, Su, Ramaha. To get a word for practical use, because we don't use Pratipadikams unless they are enjoined with Pratyayas. So we have to enjoin Pratyaya for making convenient, for make it convenient to us for creating words out of that. Ramah, Ramena, Ramaya, Ramat, Ramasya. So if one, this Nakaranta Shabda Swarupam one, if it is taken as a Pratipadikam, then one plus su. One plus su, when you add this Prathama Vibhakti Ekavachanam to a Halanta Shabdam, what will happen? Su will be omitted. Halnyabhyo dirghat sutisi apruktam hil. So it will be omitted and one will be a padam. When it becomes a padam, nalopa pratipadika antasya nakarasya lopaha bhavati. That is, the shabdas swarupam is being getting disturbed. So that is the harm in accepting anardhas shabda swarupam as here ditha we have accepted pratipadikam. Dithaha, ditham, dithena, dithaya, etc., etc., we can form the words. But on one, we cannot form words. We cannot enjoy in Vibhakti Pratyayas because this is not Ardhavat Shabda Swarupam. So only Ardhavat, that means meaningful words, word forms only can be taken as Pratipadikam. Then why he has taken Adhatuhu? A Dhatu should not be taken as Pratipadikam even though it is Ardhavat Shabda Swarupam. What is harm? We have to consider. For example, a dhatu is there. Hana himsa gachyoho. Han means generally it is to kill. Langlakara rupam of han is ahan. A is the adagama. Han is the dhatuhu. And then ti will become takara. Ahanat. Samyogantasya lopaha iti takarasya lopo bhavati. Ahan will be the shape of the word. Past tense, a word in the past tense, a kriyapadam in past tense out of han dhatuhu, ahan. Here, ahan in the shabda ahan, han is a dhatuhu. So if you take dhatu as the pratipadikam, what will happen? After han we can employ suprachayas and then again as before, suprachaya will get omitted and nakara will be omitted because it will become a padam. So, on han, because it is a dhatu, we are not supposed to treat it as pratipadikam. So, we cannot enjoy supibhaktaya over them. So, also, aprachaya. What is the harm if you take prachaya as pratipadikam? Because it is ardhavat shabda swarupam eva. That means, for example, let us take a prachaya. Karoshi. Here C is a prachaya. Madhyama purusha ekavachana latlakara prachaya. C. Karoshi. You are doing it. This, if you accept this C, this is prachaya. If you accept this C as a prachaya, then it also takes subhibhaktaya. How can you impose a subhibhakti on a subhibhakti? C itself is a subhibhakti. How can you enjoy in another supibhakti to supibhakti? This is unnatural. So that is why a prachaya, even though it has got a meaning, what is the meaning of this si prachaya? This is madhyama purusha ekavachana meaning. So this cannot be taken as pratipadikam. So also prachayanta shabdaha. Karoshi, this is prachayanta shabdaha. We cannot take this as a pratipadikam. Because a pratipadika means, on a pratipadika we are supposed to enjoy another tadhita prachaya or suprachaya. On karoshi, because it is already suprachaya antaha, we cannot superimpose another suprachaya. So that also is not to be taken as pratipadikam. We will go to the third rule. Krut tadhita samasascha. This is also pratipadikam. Because earlier in the sutra, we told that words like Rama, who are prachayantas, they cannot be taken as pratipadikam. Because it is prachayanta shabda. So, in order to make it convenient for us to take shabdas like Rama, who are prachayanta shabdas, as pratipadikams, this rule has been formed. That means, krut tadhita samasascha pratipadikam bhavanti. That means, krut is the name of a prachaya. Tadhita is the name of a prachaya. Samasa is combination of two padams. So, krut prachayanta shabdaha, tadhita prachayanta shabdaha, samasa shabdaha api pratipadikam bhavanti. So, that makes us enjoying suprachayas and krutprachayas, krutprachayanta shabdas. For example, Rama is a krutprachayanta shabda. How? Ram dhatuhu. On that, ghai is the prachaya imposed. Ram plus a. Ghai means a. Because it is having nyakara as it, that will create vruddhi in akara after rakara. Ram, akara after rakara gets vruddhi. That means it will become ra, ramaha will be the form. So, Rama is an example for krutprachayanta shabdaha. So, also all krutprachayantas. There are many krutprachayantas. Karta, krudhatuhu, trichiprachayaha, karta. This is a prachayanta shabdaha. So, on this also, kartru shabdaha. Krudhatuhu truchi prachayaha. Kartru is the pratipadikam. Ekavachanam, in subantam, ekavachanam, it becomes karta. Karta, kartarav, kartara, kartaram, kartarav, kartrun, ichadi. Harta, as an example, krutprachayanta shabdaha. Hartru is the pratipadikam. Kartru becomes karta in prathama vibhakti. Hartru becomes harta in prathama vibhakti. Karakaha, krudhatoho aka nul iti prachayaha, nul ichasya akadeshaha. So karaka is also a prachayanta shabdaha. Karaka means what? It is prachayanta shabdaha. It has got a meaning, a definite meaning. That means the person who does, the doer. Harakaha, the person who carries away. Kuru means carrying away. The person who carries away is called harakaha. Harta, the person who carries away. Kartra, the person who does. So all these are krutprachayanta shabdaha. Because of this rule, krutprachayanta shabdaha pratipadikam bhavanti. Because of this rule, now we can enjoy in suprachayas as also tadhita prachayas and all these pratipadikas. So also tadhita prachayanta shabdaha. What is one example for tadhita prachayanta shabdaha? Upagu is the name of a rushi. Upagoho apatyam puman, the son of Upaguhu, aupagavaha. This is tadhita prachayanta shabda swarupam. Upagu plus an. An is the tadhita prachaya. Upagu plus an, because of certain rules, certain actions, it becomes aupagavaha. Kapatu, the name of kapatu is a rushi's name. Kapatoho apatyam puman kapatavaha. So these are all tadhitanta shabdas. They also are taken as pratipadikam because of this rule. Samasa. Samasa contains two words. This is the combination of two words. It has got a ardhavatvam. It has, by combining two words, a definite meaning is enjoined upon them. But why a samasa should be taken? Earlier we have told ardhavat shabda swarupam. Samasa, so is ardhavat swarupam. So by that rule itself, samasa will get the pratipadikatvam. Why a separate rule taking samasa as the we are taking samasa shabda to say that is also a pratipadikam? It could be taken as a pratipadikam as per the previous rule itself. The reason is ardhavat shabda swarupam containing many words. This is samasa contains more than one word. So ardhavat shabda swarupam containing many words, in that a vakya can also be included. A sentence also contains many words. A sentence contains a definite meaning. The words therein contain a definite meaning. So the combination of words will have a definite meaning. So on a vakya also can be taken as a pratipadikam as per the previous rule. Ardhavat shabda swarupam it's told. Ardhavat shabdanam swarupam. If you take that sense, a vakya can also be taken as pratipadikam. No, but it should not be taken as pratipadikam. On a vakya, we cannot impose suprachayas. We cannot impose tadita prachayas. So, a vakya should not be taken as a pratipadikam. Samasa is taken here. If you want to take vakya also as a pratipadikam, only a samasa vakyam can be taken as pratipadikam. To mean that, to limit the vakyas, pratipadikatvam, samasa rupam vakyameva pratipadikam bhavati. To tell this truth, he has included samasa in this rule. Otherwise, a vakya can also be taken as pratipadikam. To bar all vakyas to be taken as pratipadikam, he has told a vakya means containing many words. Samasa also contains many words. If you want to take vakyam as a pratipadikam, take only samasa vakyam, not other vakyas. And then next rule says, rasvo napunsake pratipadikasya. Now we have defined what is pratipadikam. A pratipadikam, it can be a masculine gender, it can be feminine gender. For example, Rama is a pratipadikam, akaranta pullingaha. Hari is a pratipadikam, ikaranta pullingaha. Guru is a pratipadikam, ukaranta pullingaha. Gauri is a pratipadikam, ikaranta strilingaha. So this pratipadikam can admit three lingas. If it is a napumsakalinga pratipadikam, then napumsake pratipadikasya hraswatvam bhavati. That is the meaning of this. The pratipadikam containing a napumsakalinga prayuktam pratipadikam tasya hraswam bhavati, hraswaha bhavati. That the ending word will be converted into hraswa. An example we take. Atikrantam rayam ityarthe. Rayam means the money, dvitiya. Who has crossed over the money? Crossed over the money means he has not taken care of. He has neglected that money and went over. It can mean like that. So atikrantam rayam brahmana kulam. Brahmana kulam is napumsakam. Kulam means a group. A group of Brahmins is called brahmana kulam. It is a napumsakalinga shabda. Kula is the word in napumsakalinga. So atikrantam rayam brahmana kulam icharthe samaso bhavati. Ati, the word ati with rayam. Rayam is the dvitiyantam. So the pratipadikam of this rayam is rai, aikaranta rai. Ati rai will be the samasa to mean atikrantam rayam. Because we said brahmana kulam, this is napumsakalinga. Ati rai is a napumsakalinga visayakaha pratipadikaha. Pratipadikam. So atirai is a pratipadikam in napumsakalinga. So here, according to this rule, atirai, it contains aikara, dirghaha. Aikara is dirgha only. So we have to impose hraswatvam for it. We have to convert into hraswa. Aikara, the hraswa is ikara. Echa ik hraswa deshe. Iti uktam purvam. So ekarasya aikarasya hraswaha will be ikara. So atirai, because it is a pratipadikam in napumsakalinga, it is converted into hraswa. The ending letter is converted into hraswa. Ending letter aikara will become ikara. So atiri will be the pratipadika swarupam. So also atikrantam navam brahmanakulam ichardhe, again napumsakalinga. Brahmanakulam we are using because it to denote it is napumsakalinga. Atikrantam rayam ichardhe, atikrantam navam. Navam means now, now means boat. We have crossed over the boat. Atikrantam navam ichardhe, ati nau iti bhavati samasaha. Pradi samasaha. This is in napumsakalinga. So avukara, avukara will be converted to ukara when you impose rasvatvam. So atinu bhavati. Atinu kulam. Atiri kulam. Here we have taken napumsak pratipadikasya napumsakatvam eva svikrutamatra. Then only it becomes rasva. Suppose pratipadikasya pumlingam svikutam chet, even though a dirgha letter is there at the end of it, it cannot be converted into rasva letter. The example is gramam nayati ityarthe gramani, the chief of a village. We call it sarpanch nowadays. In olden times also they were there. The captain of the grama. He is called gramani. In the meaning, gramam nayati, he leads the village. Nayati means he leads. Gramam nayati charthe gramani shabdaha. Grama plus ni. This is dirga ikarantaha. This cannot be converted into hraswa. Gramani cannot be told. Why? Because gramani is a pullinga shabda. It is not napumsaka pratipadikam. Evamcha senam nayati, sena nayakaha, senam nayati ityarthe senani iti samasaha. Here also senani is a pullinga word. This ikara cannot be converted into hraswatva because it is not napumsakalinga. Pratipadikasyaiva napumsakalinge pratipadikasyaiva hraswatvam bhavati natu anyatra iti. We have to now clarify it. For example, we have got a shabda, kanda. It is a napumsakalinga shabda. Vitiya, dvivachanam for kanda is kande. Kandam, kande, kandani. Kande tishtataha. We take this vakya, sentence. Kande. This is napumsakam only, dirghantam only. That this cannot be converted into hraswanta because there is, what is the reason? It is not pratipadikam. Kande is not pratipadikam because kanda is the pratipadikam. On that we have imposed dvivachana pracheya. So kande will become a padam, not a pratipadikam. So here hraswatam is not there. But another doubt is arising here, that is hraswo napumsake pratipadikasya ichuktam. This pratipadika word is can be taken from the previous sutra. Pratipadikam is the word in that ardhavata dhatura pracheyaha. There pratipadikam is there. That pratipadikam is continued in this kruddhati samasasya. Rasvo napumsake pratipadikasya, in that rule also pratipadikam can be continued. Then when pratipadika shabda can be continued from the previous rule, why you have taken pratipadikasya again here? Pratipadikasya dvitiya grahanam kimardham is one question thought over by the grammarians. And they have, because Pāṇini is a great muni, he will not punarukti dosaha tasya nabhavati. He will not commit the fault of punarukti. Because in literature, punarukti is a dosha. You are not supposed to repeat the words unnecessarily. we can repeat the words only in on two occasions. That is, a vidyardhi is kanthastam karoti, sutranam kanthastam karoti, then he has to repeat. Punarukti dosah tatra nasti. Same way, an upadhyaya, a teacher, while teaching, he has to repeat the same sentence in different forms several times to make it understandable. If you simply say once and say golden words cannot be repeated, then teaching will not take place. He will not be a good teacher. A teacher is supposed to again and again repeat the same sentence in different formats or the same format number of times. So he there it is not a dosha. But great munis, sutrakaras, in their case, generally punarukti will not take place. Here punarukti dosha bhavitum arhati. Pāṇini mahāśayasya punarukti dosha bhavitum arhati. So to contradict punarukti dosha, the grammarians said he has taken this pratipadikasya repeatedly with a purpose. What is the purpose? The purpose is, for example, you say kande, you take the word kande. Kande is arising out of kanda shabda. Kanda is a napumsaka linga shabda, akaranta napumsaka. On that, for creating dvivachana rupam, kanda plus c, kanda plus e, kande gunam. So kande, this word is created because of a sandhi rule. Kanda plus e, kande. This is a gunasandhi. Gunasandhi, ekadesha sandhi. That means akara and ikara, you are replacing both the letters with one single letter A. So this is called ekadesha. For ekadesha shabda swarupam, we have got a rule framed by Pāṇini, antadivacha. This ekadesha rupam will be just like the anta of the previous word and adi of the next word. Here two words are there, kanda plus e. Kanda is akarantam. So if you take this kande, this ekara, ekadesha ekara, as kanda shabdavat, if you take it as a kanda shabda, that is adivat bhavati chuktam kila. Adi shabdaha kanda. Akaranta kanda shabdaha napunsakatvam. That means this A, if you take it as almost equal to the adi shabda, then we have to accept this, that A is a pratipadikam, napumsakalinga pratipadikam. Kanda is napumsakali, akaranta napumsakalinga pratipadikam. So this A, because this ekadeshaha, this is this take the equality with akaranta napumsakalinga shabda. So when this becomes kande, becomes napumsakalinga shabda, then again this rule haswo napumsake pradipadikasya, that has to be operated, and then kande, because this is ekaranta pradipadikam. Why it is becoming pradipadikam? Because antadivacha, by that sutra, this becomes pradipadikam, equal to pratipadikam. So kande, because it is pratipadikam with dirghantam, we have to operate that rule. So ekara will become ikara, kandi bhavati. To avoid that, this pratipadikasya iti taken repeatedly. We'll go to the next rule. Gostriyor upasarjanasya pradipadikasya hraswaha. That will continue from the previous sutras. Raswo Napumsake Pratipadikasya from this. That sutra, Pratipadikasya and Raswaha will continue. What is the meaning of this sutram? Pratipadikasya Upasarjanasya Go iti Upasarjanasya Pratipadikasya Stri Pratyayanta Upasarjanasya Pratipadikasya Raswaha Bhavati is the rule. If go shabda upasarjanam pratipadikam and if stri pratyayanta shabda upasarjanam bhavati pratipadikam tasya raswaha bhavati, just like in the previous sutra. Go shabda is not napumsakalinga, it is pullinga. Stri pratyayantam will be strilingam. So previous rule says napumsake. Here, that napumsaka is not taken. We will take one example. Chitraha gavaha yasya iti arthe chitra gu iti shabda. Chitraha gavaha yasya. A person having different colored cows. Chitraha means different colors. He is called Chitragu. How this shabda has come? Chitra go. Chitra will become Pumbadbhava. Chitra. Chitra go will be the samasa swarupam. Here, Chitra go, because this is Bahuvrihi samasa, both the words are upasarjanam. Because Bahuvrihi samasa is Anyapadartha Pradhanaha. A word different from these two shabdas in the samasa, that is more important than these two words. So this go shabda is a upasarjanam there, because it is a bahuvrihi samasa. So chitra go, here as per this rule, go shabdasya pratipadikasya raswaha bhavati. So chitra go will be converted to raswantam. Okarasya hraswaha ukara chitra guhu. Evam, another example we'll take. Previous example. Niradaya krantadjardhe panchamya. Nishkaushambi is the samasa. Nir has become a samasa with kaushambi. Ikaranta stri pratyayanta shabdaha. So, nishkaushambi. Here also, gostriyo rupasarjanasya. Stri pratyayantasya upasarjanam. Here also, this kaushambi is upasarjanam. Because this is nishkrantaha kaushambyaha iti, this vakyam, this vigraha vakyam indicates a person different from kaushambi. So this is also upasarjanam. So upasarjanai, stri pratyayanta upasarjanaha, here it will get raswam. So ikara will become ikara. So nishkaushambihi is the shape of the samasa. Evam cha atyadayah krantadjardhe dvitiyaya iti kachana kimchana sutram vartate. Ati etc. shabdas will become samasa with dvitiyantam shabdam nishkrantaha icharthe. Ati khatva is the samasa. That is, nishkrantaha khatvam. That is, khatva means a cot. He has crossed over the cot. In that meaning, atyadayah krantadyardhe vitiya iti sutrena, ati shabdaha khatva shabdena samasaha bhavati. Ati khatva. This khatva is a stri pratyayanta shabdaha. This is also upasarjanam here. Because nishkrantaha khatvam iti shabdaha, it is indicating a different person, anyapadartha pradhanatvam. So this khatva iti shabdaha, it will be upasarjanam in this samasa. So gostriyor upasarjanasya stri pratyayantasya upasarjanasya raswaha bhavati ityadi ardhe ati khatva iti khatva will be hraswaha akarasya hraswaha akaraha ati khatvaha iti bhavati. So also atikrantaha malam, a person who has crossed over the mala, mala means a garland, ati mala will be the samasa. Mala is a akaranta sri pratyayanta shabdaha, so it will become hraswa. Ati malaha will be the format. So with these few words we will come to our refrain for this lesson with Shanti Mantra. Om sahana bhavatu sahanau bhunaktu sahaviryam karavavahai tejasvinavadhitamastu mavidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.